Hey, hi friends, welcome to my channel. So today I'll just cover the unboxing of the echoflex. I don't think so, this is a very new product. It's launched in India quite some time back, but I just got it as part of a good deal on the Amazon Great Indian Festival. The unboxing won't be a long video. It's a quick one. It's a small box, and then I will just cover some key features of the echoflex and how you can take full advantage of it. I will not go into details of using Alexa because I think that's widely available on other YouTube videos. So let's start with first the unboxing. It's a small a box that you get, and it actually comes wrapped in a transparent plastic. I've just torn it and thrown it off. So you have the details that it has a USB-A port, a 3.5mm audio out, Bluetooth, far field voice control, microphone on off. So these are some of the things that's mentioned about the product, and some Amazon branding over here, and the price tag, all other details like the month and year of manufacture. And here you find the details of the MAC address and DSN and a barcode out here. So that's the brief introduction about the packaging. Now coming on to unboxing, there is a tape out here which I have just removed with some arrow over here. So once you just open this, the box flips open, and then you have the main content, which is the echoflex wrapped in a nice plastic wrapping, and inside we have the echoflex, the safety guide, instructions about the product handling, and then the quick user guide, which gives you all details about the location of the various ports, inputs, and how to configure it. Okay, so I will not go into much detail about this documentation because that's not what my videos are intended to be. My videos are intended to be pure hands-on. Okay, I will just keep this aside, the packaging and the guides, and I'll show you how we open this. So if you look carefully, you have a top flap over here. I initially struggled a bit how to get that done, but it's pretty simple. Just open this, and then you just open it on the left, open it on the right, and it just comes out. So there's a groove. Just wait a minute. So there's a, if you look carefully, there's a groove here, which is basically where the plug goes into. And if you remove that, you can get the Alexa echoflex, Amazon echoflex, sorry, to be that comes out. So it's quite decent. So if you take the measurements, it's about something like 3 centimeters long and around 3.5 to 4 centimeters wide. You have the LED indicator over here, 2 microphones, then the mute button. So in case at night you don't want the Alexa to listen to you, you can just mute it. Here you have the speaker. I think it's a 6-inch speaker inside. On the right hand side, you have a 3.5 mm jack through which you can connect an external speaker. Mind you, this is echoflex. This is one of the entry models for having an Amazon Alexa. So you might find the volume a bit low. and rest up on the top. It's just flat, there's nothing, and there's a USB type A port. So if you have seen the adverts of this product, you can use this as an Amazon Alexa come a charging a USB charger, because it provides around 1.5 amperes of output. Okay, so I will just progress with plugging this into a wall socket first, just to show you what are the challenges, and then I will give you a demo using an extension plug. So let's move on to a nearby wall socket. So this is the typical wall socket I have at home. As you know, it's very easy to plug into the upper ones, because that is meant for two pin devices, and these are for the three pin. But mind you, you cannot connect the echoflex to these two pins of some plug points. So I will just show you what happens is, if you try to forcefully plug in to the upper plug, it gradually slips out of it, making the installation very risky. So the best way is insert something like a screwdriver. Just give me a minute. So for the sake of this video, rather than using a screwdriver, I'm just using a pen. Be careful while inserting any devices onto the plug, because anything like a pencil might just break off. So I'm just using the pen cap, and as soon as the lower ports, oh, it's just dropped, give me a minute. So I'll start it all over again. Just insert the pen hard over here, and you can see that the lower two pins have just opened up slightly, and this is the best time to just insert the plug. Okay, so as soon as you have this inserted, now if you see from the top, it's closely connected, it will not slip out, whereas if you try to connect it to the upper pin, it slips out and it might also end up damaging the two pins from the echoflex. So be very careful. This is a very important instruction that you follow, that you need to follow. I will now move on to demonstrating the product from an extension board, because it will be easier for me to show you closely. Else I'll have to stand over here. So typically, once you have plugged in, you can just turn it on, and you will see that I have already configured this once, so the light notification might be slightly different. It takes about a minute or so. You first have a blue light which keeps blinking. And if you have bought the product through your Amazon account, what you need to do is, when it arrives home, you just need to, if you have got MAC binding enabled on your Wi-Fi router, you have to just add the MAC address which I showed you in the packaging, and then it just automatically configures. You need not enter any username, password, nothing. This can only happen provided you buy it from the same account and you also have other Amazon devices at home. So I have got two Fire TV sticks at home, so the indication of the light stop blinking means the echoflex is now ready. And I will also demonstrate to you how it the level of volume. Initially it is quite low, but through the Alexa app on the phone. Okay, so I spoke the wake up word.
No, telephones are not mobile phone applications.
Okay, so you can understand that I spoke about the keyword Alexa. Okay, and that triggers it. You can change it as per what you want. So through the app, when you configure it, or you need to just speak out and say, Alexa, maximum volume. Okay, it doesn't give you any kind of an audio indication, but it sets to maximum volume. Otherwise, for the first time when you turn it on, it is very low and you might just feel disappointed. So don't get disappointed, just spend some time exploring the product, and I think it's worth an investment. So let's move on to a few other feature demo. So now I have moved on to an extension port, power port, and to explain few of the features, I'll be using a JBL Flip 3 speaker, USB type A to micro USB, which is a charging cable, and also an EP stereo to EP stereo audio cable I'll be using, just to show various features what you can use it. So I have a problem with my speaker that it runs out of battery soon, and in the current lockdown scenario I am unable to get the batteries changed. So what I'll do is I'll use the first feature of Alexa, which is the type A USB port. Okay, I have connected the type A USB port. Now I'll just show you that rather than saying the wake up word, which is Alexa, if you just want to press the wake up key and speak out, you can do so. What's the time?
It's 8:41 p.m.
Okay, so you have the audio coming out from the speakers over here, and you have the mute button. So if I press this, the light turns red, and you have an indicator showing that it's muted. So if I speak out the wake up word, which is Alexa, Alexa, it doesn't respond because the two microphones over here are muted. And mind you, I plan to connect this just behind my television in a closed, quite a closed place. So since there are some wooden boxes out there, the audio echo is actually amplifies my voice, and these microphones are able to pick up my voice pretty clearly. Okay, so these were the two features about the wake up button and also the mute. You have the type USB type A port here. Now I will connect, as I said, my JBL speakers run out of batteries, so I will connect the USB cable and charge it through the echoflex. So okay, it has started charging. Okay, now if you see, it already shows paired, because on my echoflex I have already paired the JBL speaker, and I will just show you how it really sounds using the JBL speakers through the Bluetooth. So I will also show in my video that for the first time how you need to do the pairing using the Alexa app. Alexa, what's the time?
It's 8:44 p.m.
Okay, so you can make out the difference, and so if you have good Bluetooth speaker at home, it makes no sense going for a bigger Amazon Alexa. The echoflex should be good enough. Now in case you don't have a Bluetooth speaker, then you can also make use of the stereo port over here and connect the speaker. So I will connect it over here. Okay, and I will just say, Alexa, disconnect Bluetooth. Okay, so my Bluetooth speaker has turned, the indicator has turned from blue to white. That means it's no more paired with the Alexa. Just because I connected the audio jack, you couldn't hear the announcements. So, Alexa, what's the time?
The time is 8:45 p.m.
Alexa, what's the time?
It's 8:45 p.m.
Okay, so in case if you want to increase the volume, you have the volume controls on the speaker, JBL speaker, through which you can increase it. So this is how you can use the any speaker, both in the Bluetooth as well as using the aux cable out here, and the output is very good. The advantage of using the Bluetooth is you can just have the echoflex plugged in to your plug point, and you can just keep the JBL or any other Bluetooth speaker quite far off. So after I show you this demo, I'll also show you how to do the pairing with a Bluetooth speaker. So once the pairing is done, once you turn on your speaker for the first time after the pairing's done, you just need to say, Alexa, connect to Bluetooth.
Searching.
Okay, so you hear a beep, which indicates that the echoflex is now connected to the Bluetooth speaker. And once you have finished listening to music or any other echoflex activities, you can just say, Alexa, disconnect from Bluetooth. It's now disconnected. I'll also show you the level of volume that you get once you set an alarm. So alarm is one of the most interesting features due to which I went for this product, because I already own a Google Home Mini, which is there in my living room, and I plan to use it in my bedroom as a secondary smart speaker, useful for executing few commands like turning on AC, turning off AC, turning on and off lights. So let's see this feature of alarm too, which is very interesting. Alexa, set an alarm for 10 seconds.
Alarm set for 8:49 p.m.
So this is a very soft, soothing alarm. Mind you, for the first time when the product is set up, you will find the volume much lower, which you can either say using the ALEXA command and saying max volume, just like I showed you, or you can do using the same through your Android app. Alexa, snooze. Now I'll just set the same thing through the Bluetooth speakers, and you will really make out the difference. Alexa, cancel all alarms.
Cancelling all your alarms.
Okay, so we saw how the Bluetooth speaker was paired. We could connect and disconnect to the Bluetooth speaker. So I have now unpaired it from the flex. I'm calling it flex because I have now changed the wake up word from Alexa to echo. There are multiple ways, multiple options for it to be changed. And I'll also show you how to pair the Bluetooth speaker for the first time. So on Amazon, on my iPad, I just opened the Alexa app, and you have the section of devices, and in devices you can see the section echo and Alexa. Just open that and you'll find the device out here. And here there are various settings. So the first one I will show you is how to change the wake word. If you scroll down, LED display, sounds, do not disturb. So just below device location, you'll find time zone, and then you'll find wake word. So if you click this, you will find various options: Alexa, Amazon, computer, and echo. So you see the last option checked for me. Now from this, if I want to change it to Alexa, I just click on this, and you will see that as soon as I have clicked that, it gives you a warning: updating your wake word may take a few minutes. You can continue using your current wake word during this update. Okay, so I click on OK, and now you will see that there's a red light that keeps popping, and it's pretty quick. So from Echo, if I change it to Alexa, it's pretty quick, but for the first time when you change it, it takes few seconds for the change to be implemented. So that is how you change the wake word. Now I will we are back to the main EchoFlex configuration settings. So here you can see that you have the volume slider through which you can change it, and if you click on audio settings, you can change the bass, mid-range, and the treble. With my JBL speakers, I didn't require this to be changed much because it was pretty decent with the default settings. And now I want to go into the section of Bluetooth devices. If you see, it says no paired Bluetooth device found. What you need to do is just click on pair a new device. It goes into a searching mode, and you also see the blue lights on. So on my JBL speakers, I just need to click on the Bluetooth, and as soon as it starts making the noise, you will So now if you see, after searching, it was able to find available devices. So my JBL Flip 3's name is Montane Flip 3. I just click that.
Your device wasn't paired.
So due to certain reasons, it's not paired. Let me give it another try.
Connected to Montane Flip 3. Now that you're paired, next time just say, connect my speaker.
Okay, you get that notification. This is paired now. It shows under the list of paired devices. So I just click on cancel because I don't need to pair any further devices. Now if you see, it shows Bluetooth devices and one paired. I can just say, Alexa, disconnect Bluetooth.
Now disconnected from Montane Flip 3.
Alexa, connect to Bluetooth.
Searching.
Okay, so that's one of the interesting settings you have which you need to work around. Sometimes the pairing fails, you just need to turn off and turn on your speakers once again and give it another try. There's also another option to make one of your Fire TV stick remotes as an eco remote, but somehow it didn't work, so I won't be able to demonstrate that in this video. You also have the option to tune the intensity, the brightness of the LED display which you see over here on the top. So it is currently set to something around 80%, I would say, and I will just increase the brightness to 100%. So now if I say Alexa, so it's pretty bright. And
sorry, I don't know that.
And now if I drag it to minimal and just say Alexa, so you can make out that the brightness has significantly decreased, and I think 80 to 90 percent, this seems to be something like 93%. So 80 to 90% is a good brightness level, and you may not be required to tweak around with it. You can also change the clock format from a default 12-hour clock to a 24-hour clock through the Alexa app. I also tried to call one of my friends in UK right now, and it worked very well. So I just spoke the wake word and just said call, followed my friend's name who has an Alexa device. But surprisingly, what he found is the call landed on his phone rather than on his Alexa device. But he could get a very good audio quality. But I did not see that the output came from the Bluetooth speakers. Rather, it was from the echoflex device. I think probably at that point of time my Bluetooth wasn't paired. So that's fine. That's another useful thing. You can use it to call friends across Alexa. So that did not consume any international calling charges for me. It landed straight away. I don't think so. From an Alexa device to a phone is currently supported in India, but in UK it is supported, so that works fine. Okay, you also have other options to pair some subwoofers and stereo speakers, but since I don't have any of those devices, I won't be able to demonstrate that. You can also tweak around with some sounds, like for alarms, timers and notification, you can set the volume. You can also set whether you want to have a straightaway fixed volume settings for alarm or a gradual increasing one. So that's also pretty nice. The demo for the alarm I've already showed you before, so I won't be repeating that again. So you have various types of alarms which you can customize, and you have an incoming call ringer. So for anyone calling from their Alexa device to this, you can set the incoming call ringer. And I have also turned on the setting start of request. So when I say Alexa, you hear this sound. That is the start of request. So I feel very comfortable to hear that. That tells me that the device is activated and ready to listen.
Sorry, I don't know that.
Okay, so some interesting messages coming from Alexa. I also heard that Alexa now supports the voice of one of Bollywood famous stars, Amitabh Bachchan. So if I say Alexa, talk to Amitabh Bachchan.
अरे हेलो, दिस इज अमिताभ बच्चन, और आपका हेलो जो है वो हम तक पहुंच गया है, पर आगे की बातें जो है ना वो हम बाद में करेंगे जब हम होंगे अलेक्सा के साथ.
दैट्स राइट, मैं भी इंतजार कर रही हूँ जब अमिताभ बच्चन, आप और मैं खूब सारी बातें कर सकते हैं. फिलहाल आपसे गुफ्तगू के लिए मैं यही हाजिर हूँ.
Interesting. So there are various other settings also which you can play around with on the app, like follow-up mode. It is very similar to the Google, wherein after speaking, raising some questions with the Flex, you can continue asking follow-up questions based on the answers. I typically turn that off because I found that disturbing. You can change the language from English to any other language, the measurement units, and this is registered under my name. So these are some of the key features I've really used on this app as well as on the device. I'm exploring further and I will try to add more to this as I learn further. Hope you will like this video of mine, and if you have any further questions or comments, do not forget to write it in the comment section. Thanks for watching this video, and have a great time with the echoflex. Alexa, thank you so much.
Anytime.